excesses of Russia, right? Mm-hmm. Yes, the Professor Silkin, and his work is very focused on our same research field, okay? So, would you welcome his lecture with warm applause?
I am Vladimir Silkin. I am head of laboratory of ecology of Institute of Oceanology, Russian Academy of Science. I am also oceanologist. And now I want to say you about our work in our laboratory. Help me, please. Next slide. Where is?
Yeah.
Okay. Back in front. The main activity is of our laboratory is the mechanism formation of the phytoplankton compound structure. Why is important? Phytoplankton communic structure determines the work of biological carbon pump in the ocean, and the biological carbon pump determines the climate of our planet. The next. We have many work in the theory of main microalgae cultivation and seaweed cultivation. In this field, we have two books: one book on the theory microalgae cultivation, another book on the seaweed cultivation. I hope in the future we will adopt this book for student lecture. With help, Professor Deng. And we have some work in the ecological application of our theoretical study. This direction is the harmful algae bloom, and in the early this was the toxic algae bloom in the sea. And another ecological application is ballast water treatment. And in the next, the theory on invasive process. I have only presentation for this conference yesterday, and now I use this presentation for you. And some words about the harmful algae bloom. Harmful algae bloom and the grand ecological problems for all countries in the world. This problem is also for China. I choose in the literature one presentation of China scientists, and we can see that harmful algae bloom is a big problem for China. We can see that the Bohai Bay is also a problematic zone for harmful algae. The species is also for different sea. All species is similar for different country, for different sea. There is only one method for study toxic algal bloom. This method is monitoring. In our laboratory, we add this method by a new technology. Is this technology as experiment with natural population. When you sampling the sampling phytoplankton sampling in the sea, we work with natural population by flow methods. This method include some experiment with different level of environmental factors. For Black Sea, for different sea, this factor is different. For Black Sea, we choose only two factors, is nitrogen and phosphorus concentration. In this picture, the scheme of nitrogen and phosphorus addition is the culture. By this scheme, we have opportunity to receive very interesting result. The usual pattern, the dynamic, biomass dynamic on different species in the batch culture is similar. And different species have different reaction for addition of nitrogen and phosphorus addition. In this picture, we can see that reaction of reaction coccolithophorida, coccolithophorus, Malania huxley for different addition of nitrogen and supply. And we see the we can see that phosphorus is a main in the main regulator of the growth of these species. We study the reaction of different species during one addition nitrogen and phosphorus during long time, 15 years. And we have one pattern. The small diatom, small diatom have one reaction. Coccolithophorus and Malania huxley has another reaction. And third reaction. Third reaction is the reaction of large diatom. Only three class reaction. It's very interesting because by using this reaction we have opportunity to divide ecological situation in the sea for three classes. It's very very interesting for forecast for toxic algal bloom of these species. These large species. These species is there are the species in the Bahai Sea. We have opportunity to receive reaction of these different species for addition nitrogen and phosphorus additions, and by use of these equations, we we know the reaction of all species. All species all species in the sea, and we have opportunity forecast and to prevent toxic algae bloom of this species. But there are nucleus species. And this equation, regression for small diatom and for carpentophores. We can see that the different reaction. No, but there are two class of phytoplankton which we cannot forecast and to prevent this toxic bloom. This small dinoflagellate is typical species for different species in the sea, and this species on Scripsella edinodini is typical for Bahai Sea. Another class is the large dinoflagellates. And we can see this dinophysis, serosum, in the species, it's very difficult to forecast. And now we work with the problem to study and of these species in the sea. It's very difficult to work because these species have different growth strategies. And geotrophic dinoflagellates, this dinoflagellate Noctilucus tintilis, and the only geotrophic species. The toxic bloom of these species was fixed in the Bahai Sea also. To prevent this invasive process in the different sea, International Maritime Organization proposed standard D2 for ballast water after treatment. According to this convention of this organization, all ship must have ballast system for ballast water management. And after this system, water must consist only small number species, different size class. First class plankton. Size class, minimal size class, near 50 micrometer. Another size class, 10-50 micrometer. It's very hard task to receive to solve this problem. It's usually the system of ballast water management consists is two systems. First system is the filter, another system after filter is a UV light system. life system, and this system is have this system. It's very difficult to receive results. According standard G2 of International Maritime Organization, there is now another problem. When we construct the system for water treatment in the ship, you need to test this system in the special system of the testing. But we have another problem. The water, what used in this system, must have the same concentration of plankton, species. I want to say you that is the all sea water. This concentration, the concentration of this size group near 1,000 lower than need. We can see our system for testing. For testing, this system consisting from two reservoirs and. To reservoir and the system of filter and UV light system. For solution was on the one problem and the increasing of level plankton concentration, we use the intensive culture of the Nurella salina, and we have new technology and regulation size cell. In this technology we used for our work, we received very very good results. In this picture, we can see that our young staff edit the microalgae culture of Donella Salina in the reservoir for testing system. I want to say you that problem the ballast water treatment may be solved very 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 simple when we use very intensive culture of marine species. And now we study the theory of invasion process and in this various mathematical model in this picture we can see that very simple mathematical model. We receive very interesting results on this calculator for readers. here small and large dinoflagellate. We receive the results with recordings of our theory. In this picture, some work in the different journal, and different work we found in the research gate. I believe you know ResearchGate.
Yeah.
ResearchGate. And then the name Silkin.
We can find
publication of our laboratory.
Yeah, ecology.
Finish.
Okay, in our college, this is some seminal research work in our college. So, okay, 大家看有没有什么问题？我想我们学院很多有助这方面的，就找位啊、围找。大家看有没有什么有问题的，大家提问。另外呢，就是我通知一下我们的老师们，当然我们的那个圈，你们说外边我们是吧？刚才呢，院士还说他刚刚是讲了他自己一点的东西，实际上我们这师范的可以交流一下，他有个学院，我刚才确认了，他们还是叫格鲁吉亚技术大学，就是他们相当。